Magic spells are great. Ikoria's the newest set and the Timmies have their way. Hey! Magic spells are great. If I play more red deck wins and magic won't be great. Hey! Oh, hello there, my nerdos. I did not know you guys were there. I hope my horrible singing did not scare you, but it certainly feels like Christmas with spoiler season upon us. So what cards are you guys excited about? Because we're going to talk about some decks today. So let's go ahead and join me on to the next part. Welcome to the Cube Gaming. It's your boy Halo Spades, and we're back at it again with another video. This time, we're doing it with some deck techs. Now, I have been seeing a lot of spoilers, and there's so many of the cards that really excite me. But one of the bunch of cards that I saw that really got me excited for this new set is General Kudrow of Dranith. I think I'm saying it right because it's fairly still new to me. And one of my favorite cards in the current standard that's been going around since Ravnica Allegiance has been Hero of Precinct 1. So it got me to get ideas to brewing. Now, I have three different deck techs here. Two of them I like a lot. One's not so much. But then the another one, it was a kind of begrudgingly made deck because those colors usually win a lot. So you kind of got to go with winners. So we're going to go in the order of the ones that I don't like to the ones that I like. So save the best for last, okay? So bear with me here. I'm going to pull up my laptop. I can't remember all the cards. So the first one is going to be, and the one thing that ties all these decks together is it's all about humans. So it's only humans. All right. So the first one is an Esper, We Can Be Heroes deck. Now, some of the cards that I have here are four generals and forces. Now, I am going to have the links, by the way, for you. Don't keep up or don't have time to watch the full video in the descriptions down below. Make sure if you like what you see here, you subscribe, ring that notification bell so you don't miss out on any future videos that come out. We do all types of stuff here, such as gameplays, tutorials, product openings, as well as deck techs. Okay, so the first card that I'm going to talk about is General's Enforcer. This is a one white and a black 2/3. A human soldier. It's an uncommon that legendary creatures you control have indestructible. So that kind of ties in well with what we've got going on here. Okay, now it has an activated ability that's pretty nifty. So if you're getting mana flooded late game, you actually have a way to use something on this ability to help you out. And what it says is two, a white and a black, exile target card from a graveyard. If it was a creature card, create a 1/1 white human soldier creature token. Now that comes in handy against decks like Euro decks or anything that runs Kroxa or even cat decks, but we'll cover those in just a bit and how you battle those pretty good, mainly because it's human and those colors right there, they actually trigger, you know, the Hero of Precinct 1, which the deck is all about. Obviously you got to have your staple card in there, which is Hero of Precinct 1. Got to have your four of those guys in there. We even went and actually added an extra twist, maybe because this is a fun card that I actually enjoyed during the time it came out, and it's still seeing play, but in different types of builds right now. And that is Priest of the Forgotten Gods. Okay, one, it's a human. Bing, bing, bing. What do we got? Synergy. Yay. But also, with Hero of Precinct 1 and all the triggers that you get off of Hero, you have fodder to actually sack to the Priest of the Forgotten Gods and not actually lose out your valuable creatures if you don't need to, okay, thereby helping you draw cards, sacking pesky creatures if there's a Dream Trawler out, need extra mana. It's a utility knife, you know, one of those Swiss Army knives there. So we have four of those. We have three General Kudrow. I'm probably thinking maybe we should run four because you definitely want to see this card. He is a lord. He gives your other humans +1/+1, which is pretty nifty. And whenever he enters the battlefield, it says here, whenever General Kudro of Draneth or another human enters the battlefield under your control, exile target card from an opponent's graveyard. So that right there, just that alone is valuable. And then with Hero of Precinct 1, it triggers it. So boom, boom, boom. And then your 1-1s are now 2-2s. So now you have a pretty aggressive deck going on here. Now another card that we have in here that's actually from Theros, Beyond Death, is actually a pretty fun one. It's called Atris, Oracle of Half-Truths. I didn't know if this was a human or not. I thought it was maybe a zombie or something. But when I double-checked, it is a human. Congratulations. We have us a winner here. And it has been seeing some fringe play in some decks here. It's got Menace. It's a 3-2 with a pretty relevant ETB effect. So another way to get more cards into your hand, as well as triggering Hero of Precinct 1, as well as, you know, benefits from General Kudro of Draneth. And also, it's the legendary, so it gets indestructible from the General's Enforcer. So, bam, another value right there. For the other top end, so I don't like having this many four drops, so we have a total of 6 in the deck. We have 2 Elite Guard Mages. Why do we have those in here? Well, it's a human. I shouldn't have to explain that already. It's got flying. When an Elite Guard Mage enters the battlefield, you gain 3 life and you draw a card. What's to not like about that? But did I forget to mention that it also triggers Hero of Precinct 1? Who loves that? Now, of course, since we are in Esper colors, blue-white specifically, you gotta have your mandatory Teferis. I don't know how Teferi really fits in this, but it's an annoying card to play against, so why not play it? Here you have Teferi, Hero of Precinct 1. Now, some new cards that we get from the set as well, other than just the humans, we get Dire Tactics. You're going to run 4 of them because, you know, you always want to start off with 4. Yes, it does target creatures, but it's pretty good. Exile target creature. It's an instant. If you don't control a human, you lose life equal to that creature's toughness. Most of the times you will control a human. Most of the times. So maybe you could go down on these cards and maybe switch it out for something else. I don't know what else you'd want to put in. That's your call to make. But this is the list that I'm pretty confident with. You got to have your mandatory Thought Erasers, 4 of those, because who loves being Thought Erasured? Not me. Thought Erasure. They always do it back to back to back. Oh. All right. Back at it. Let's just not think about those traumatizing times. We also have 2 Othakayas. It's mostly because of the life gain. There's a lot of red decks out there right now, so this is also the trigger Hero Precinct 1. And also to gain you some life. And then for lands, we have 25 of those bad boys in here. We have 2 Castle Ardenvales. Why? Because they create humans. Remember, we're human-centered. We have 1 Castle Lochthwain because you got to draw cards. We have 1 Castle Ventress so you could scry. So maybe you're running into a pocket of mana or whatever. You just need to look for an answer. You could do so. 4 Godless Shrine. 4 Hollowed Fountain. 2 Island. 1 Plains, 2 Swamp, 2 Temple of Deceit, 2 Temple of Enlightenment, and 4 Watery Graves. Now for the sideboard, I didn't know what to do, but I did throw in a bunch of new ones in here as well too. I have 3 Agonizing Remorse for those decks that you really have to go in their hands as much as possible. So because in case Thought Erasure wasn't enough to get the job done, I have 2 Devout Decree because you got Mono Black still running around, you still got Rakdos running around, but it also helps you scry one. You got 3 Dovin's Vetoes. I don't think I need to explain Dovin's Vetoes because it helps out your deck against those decks that don't want you to have fun. Dovin's Veto is kind of neato. Now, this is a new addition here. I'm not sure if it's a great call. I think it's good. I could be wrong. This is a real big hoser. This is a big-time hate bear if I've ever seen one. This is Draneth Magistrate. It's 1 and a white, 1-3. Your opponents can't cast spells from anywhere other than their hands. So if there's any red deck wins out there still running Experimental Frenzy, well, you just hose yourself because now you can't play anything until you get rid of your frenzy. So have fun there, buddy. Hey, Euro, we didn't get to hit you yet? No problem. Well, you can't come out of the graveyard, buddy. So, and not that this is a major issue, you got the jumpstart cards that you can't recast. So you only get 1 time value out of it. If there's any wily person running jumpstart, All right. So I also have, and this is a new one. This is kind of iffy. I don't know if I like it or not, but it triggers the hero, and it's not a human, but it's valuable. And you got to put value cards when you see them. This is Lurrus of the Dream Den. This is a one in a hybrid white-white or black-black. And it's a legendary creature, Cat Nightmare, and has companion. Each permanent card in your starting deck has converted mana cost 2 or less. And this has lifelink. It's a 3-2. And then during each of your turns, you may cast one permanent spell with converted mana cost 2 or less from your graveyard. That is pretty potent, if you ask me. I have two because I'm not sure of this card, and I don't know what the value of this card will be. We also have two Elspeth Sun's Nemesis on the sideboard because it creates humans with a minus 2 ability, but it also it pumps up your creatures that are already out on the battlefield, or you can gain 5 life, or you could escape it later on if you need to. So it's not too bad to have in your deck. And then I have one Ethereal Absolution. I didn't know what to throw in the deck. Honestly, I was just looking for all types of multicolored spells that I could find, and this is one of the better ones, I think, that I liked for the sideboard. So I went ahead and threw it in there. So let's get on to the next one that I like, but I'm not too sure of, because I've done well with this color schematic with the Hero of Precinct 1. And what that one is the Abzan Human Heroes. And obviously it's Abzan. We're still going to be running 4 Generals Enforcers. 4 Hero Precinct 1, we're not going to go over those. 3 Generals, which we may even push that to 4. But the differences we have here is we have 2 Cheville Bane of Monsters. That is a swamp and a forest. He's a 1-3 with Death Touch. With at the beginning of your upkeep, if your opponent controls no permanent with bounty counters on them, put a bounty counter on target creature or planeswalker an opponent controls. Whenever a permanent an opponent controls with a bounty counter on it dies, you gain 3 life and draw a card. That's pretty sweet if you ask me, just that value alone. It's a 2-drop, comes down pretty early. Most importantly, it triggers your Hero of Precinct 1. We're only running 2 of those because I'm not too confident with that card. Another card that I have in this one is Skull Prophet. It's a swamp in the forest. It's a human druid. It's a 3-1. You could either tap to add a swamp or forest mana, or you could tap and put the top 2 cards of your library into your graveyard. I don't have it mainly for the second ability. I have it for the triggering of Hero of Precinct 1 and for, you know, Dranith and General Kudrow, not Dranith. His name is not Dranith. He is from Dranith. So I don't know the lore, so please forgive me. We have 4 of those guys in here. And then for the non-creature spells, we have 1 Kaya Orzhov Usurper. I have her in here because she's good at exiling the cat. Okay. She's good at exiling Euros. Like, the whole point is pretty much is to fight against those type of decks, but also she gains you life from if you exile a creature card, so there's nothing wrong with that. And again, Hero of Precinct 1. I have a 1 Soren Vengeful Bloodlord. Now, I put this in here because I couldn't find enough spells that I thought were relevant. So he's in here because he's good and gets someone that plays board wipe, so you could actually bring your creatures back from the graveyard. Okay, so they'll be human and slash vampires, or you could just tick them up, keep taking them up, you know, finish off that Teferi that your opponent plays or something like that, or what have you. And you also gain life from it. Maybe you could run 2. But I don't want to be too top heavy on this deck. This is mostly trying to be an aggressive deck. And then you got 3 Vraska Golgari Queen. Now, one of the things that I've learned about Hero of Precinct 1, everyone looked at Vraska and was like, nah, it's not a great planeswalker. When whatever they complain about. But when you pair this with a card like Hero of Precinct 1, you can sacrifice that token and draw a card. That is value, if I've ever seen value. That is value town for days. Now, we have some new spells here. Dire Tactics, it's 4 of mandatory. I also threw in 3 Assassin's Trophy in here because a lot of decks right now are running greedy mana bases. So chances are they don't always have, you know, a basic land to go grab. So if you hit them with an Assassin's Trophy, it's probably going to hurt them more than it will help them. Obviously, you don't want to do it early game, but it also answers a lot of problems. So I have 3 of them in the deck. From the set that's coming out, I have 3 Fight as 1. It's a 1 mana It's white. It's an instant that choose one or both. Target human creature you control gets +1/+1 and gains in this. Wow, I didn't even read the one or both. I thought it was one or the other. Target human creature you control gets +1/+1 and gains indestructible until end of turn. Target non-human creature you control gets +1/+1 and gains indestructible until end of turn. I think that's a pretty good deal if you ask me. So you can put a non-human creature in here. And I think it might be a good idea maybe to put in the Seraph of the Scales just because of the evasion. And I don't know. I just think it's a pretty good card, but it's not been seeing much play anymore. I have one Casualties of War. I don't know if I need to explain this card because all these Fire Emblem Inventions decks running around. I mean, and any other pesky decks that you might run into. I have one Fine Finality. It's mostly for the fine side of things, but if you need the finality part, you guess what? You kind of have an option to get out of there. And then your two Othakayas. Excuse me. We only have 24 lands in this one. I know I should probably be running 25, especially since we're running Casualties of War and a Fine Finality and four drops. That could be changed. I don't know what to cut for that, though. Maybe a Assassin's Trophy for another land. I don't know. You make that call. That's you guys test it out. Let me know what you think. Also, if you are liking what you see here, please leave a comment down below. Let me know which of these three decks we go over today you do like. So let me know what you like there. All right. Bounce the mana base. We have two Castle Ardenvale, two Castle Lochthwain, two Fabled Passage, which I should probably make those the Scry lands. One Forest, four Godless Shrine, four Overgrown Tomb, two Plains, three Swamp, and four Temple Garden. Now, sideboard, I have four Agonizing Remorse, two Despark, two Devout Decree, two Heliod's Intervention for life gain against those aggressive decks. This is where I have the Seraph of the Scales at, and it's two in the sideboard. And I have another Casualties of War. And then I have two Fine Finalities. Again, I might be making, you know, bad calls on that, but I put these together as quick as I could. I just wanted to throw those cards together because how fun they are. Now, we're going to go on to my personal favorite one. And this is something that made an appearance in the early Ravnica Allegiance set. And it was causing trouble for a lot of people. And then eventually Esper came and pooped on the parade there, so... This one is Heroes of Mardu. Now, these are my favorite colors. I don't know why, I wish I could tell you. And in this one, we got the basics. In Generals and Forces, Hero Precinct, one Priest of Forgotten God, and General Kudro. Now, the things that are different from the other decks is we run four Fireblade Artists. Okay, it's a 2-2 with haste, which is pretty relevant now. Haste is really crucial. But it also has an extra ability in your upkeep. So if you have a, you know, token from your Hero Precinct 1 and you manage to get an upkeep trigger, you can sack it and deal 2 to the face, you know? Or let me see, is it to the face or is it to anywhere? Let's see. So target opponent or planeswalker. That's pretty good. And it also triggers Hero. We also have 2 Judith the Scourge Diva because she pumps your team up. And also there's triggers off of Hero and then triggers when your creatures die. Then we have 2 Tajik Legion's Edge because he triggers and he's got haste and mentor makes your stuff bigger. And it also prevents non-combat damage. So anyone running Deafening Clarions are going to have a hard time. But another thing too is with General's Enforcer, it actually has a nice synergy there because it gives legendaries indestructible. And he gives prevent all damage from non-combat damage. So I think we're onto something. Now, the only non-human in this deck is because I like this card a lot. It looks really good. And I think you can abuse this, which I'm probably going to make more decks with this card just on the stats alone, is Luminous Broodmoth. It's 2 in a planes and a planes. It's got flying. Now, whenever a creature you control without flying dies, return it to the battlefield under its owner's control with a flying counter on it. And it's a 3-4. That is bonkers. That I want to put Kroxa in this deck so bad just because of that. But I might just build a different type of Mardu deck to put that together with Kroxa and any other nasty ETB effects. Because I want to abuse them as much as I can. And then to make matters even worse, you're going to make them discard so many cards. Oh, that's so fun. I love it. I love it. All right, and our Planeswalkers, we have two Kaias in here. So, sorry to get sidetracked there, but just thinking of what the devious things I want to do with that card. Oh, so exciting. So, we have two Kaya Orzhov Usurper. Okay, no need to explain her. Three fight is one, four dire tactics. Again, those are all, they're pretty much tied, two of the Kaias. We have a 24 land base, and we can actually get away with that here because we're not really running anything really top heavy. We just have the two Luminous Broodmoth in the main. And we have four, excuse me, I'm just looking, making sure we didn't have anything else in the deck. We have four Blood Crypts, two Castle Ardenvale, one Castle Lochthwain, four Godless Shrine, three Mountain, three Plains, four Sacred Foundry, three Swamps. Those could probably be changed like Temple of Silences and Temple of Triumphs and stuff like that. Again, it's at your discretion. I think I might make that change because scrying is so valuable. Our sideboard has three Agonizing Remorse, two Devout Decree, three Drowneth Magistrate, I didn't know what else to put in, two Elspeth Sun's Nemesis, three Seraph of the Scales, and then two Shatter the Sky. I know you're probably saying Shatter the Sky. There's been a lot of Cavalier decks running around. There's been a lot of big, heavy creatures, so the little guys probably can't get past them. So that's just a fail-safe in case things don't work out as planned. So that is all three of the decks. These are the humans decks. Let me know which one you like best. Let me know what changes you would want to make to these decks. I'm curious to know what you guys think. Also, let me know what cards you guys are brewing about, because I like this time of the year. This is the best time for me as a Magic player, despite the, you know, given current situation we're going on right now. Hopefully we can get back to paper Magic and normality soon. But please make sure you guys are staying safe out there. Take care of each other. This is the perfect time that we got to come together as one. We are one community. We all come to Magic to escape from the, you know, craziness that's out there in the world. So thank you guys for being here. Make sure to leave a like, leave a subscribe, and let me know what you think. Wait, what's this?
Ho, 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 ho! Hello there, Halo. I heard you like Magic, so I brought you an early gift. Ho, 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 ho
see what it is. It is a Magic Collector's Bundle. I've always wanted one of these. How did you know? Thank you, Santa.
Hey, where's all the cards? Well, let's see what we got here. What? Oh, this is not good. What? Who wants this?